Hello, I'm Madeline Pickens, and today I'll be performing a gel electrophoresis to identify a mutation for breast cancer. Before starting any experiment, it's really important to clean your workspace to prevent cross-contamination. This is our gel for the gel electrophoresis. We're going to be using a micropipette to load 10 microliters of each sample into the corresponding well. We'll start with the DNA standard marker. Our next sample is Harold, who does not have breast cancer being the gene we are looking for in this experiment. Next is Helen, who has breast cancer, and we can use her DNA to see if it's genetic. Next is Adam, who also has breast cancer. This DNA sample is from Susan, who we don't know if she has a breast cancer gene or not, and so we're going to use these other samples to see if she has a genetic mutation for breast cancer. Finally is our negative control, which has no DNA and therefore should produce no results. This is our gel electrophoresis chamber, and we are going to pit our loaded gel right here with the wells near the negative side of the chamber. That's because our DNA has a negative charge, so when we run the electrical charge through here, the DNA will move towards the positive side. Next, we're going to carefully pour in our buffer solution until it just covers the top of the gel. First, I'm going to clean up any extra buffer that spilled, and then I will place the top of the gel electrophoresis chamber on so that we can start the power. Now we're going to plug the other ends of the top of the gel electrophoresis chamber into here. So we'll start with the red. And then do the black. And then we will plug in our power source. Then we can turn this on and set it to 125. And then we can hit run. We've let the gel run for about 25 minutes, so we're going to turn off, unplug the power supply, and then wait about 10 seconds before we unplug the gel electrophoresis chamber. With everything unplugged, we can now take off the top. This is our transilluminator, which we will use to look at the DNA. We're going to take our gel and put it on here, and then turn off the lights. Now we're going to close the top and turn it on.
It's a little difficult to catch the results of the gel electrophoresis on camera, so I recreated it on the whiteboard here so I can show you and analyze the results. Here we have our six lanes with our DNA marker, which has specified lengths of DNA. Harold, who tested negative or doesn't have breast cancer. Helen, who has breast cancer. Adam, who has breast cancer. Susan, who we don't know, and our negative control. You can see here that the pieces of DNA move down towards the positive side, and because they are different lengths, they move down at different speeds, the smaller pieces moving down faster or further. So what we want to do is we can see that Helen and Adam both have these matching lengths of genes or base pairs, and they both have breast cancer. But Harold does not have this matching piece, and he does not have breast cancer. So what we can take from this is that here you can see Susan also has this matching length that corresponds. So Susan most likely has the BRCA1 or BRCA2 genes, or a mutation that makes her more likely to get breast cancer genetically.